So yeah, let me introduce myself. My name is Tom Quinn. I'm a postdoctoral research fellow at the Applied Artificial Intelligence Institute at Deakin University. I first trained as a clinician, but now I work mostly as a methodologist developing new algorithms and software tools for microbiome data analysis. I'm especially interested in designing interpretable deep learning models that bring transparency to biomarker-based prediction tools. I'll be presenting today also on behalf of my colleague, Amy Loughman, who, like myself, started out in a clinical track and is now a microbiome researcher. She studies the link between the gut microbiome and mental health disorders at the Food and Mood Center, which is also at Deakin University. And we work together to create predictive models based on human gut microbiome biomarkers. There's a lot of speakers here today, and it's getting close to lunch, so I'll keep what I have to say short and simple. What we're proposing is a research endeavor that will bring together our extended network of computer scientists, bioinformaticians, clinicians, nutritionists, and other domain experts to tackle a big opportunity in the microbiome and human performance space. From our perspective, one of the biggest components of human performance is mental health, with disorders of mental health being responsible for a tremendous amount of morbidity and mortality worldwide. There's growing evidence in the literature that the microbiome, especially the gut microbiome, may be linked directly or indirectly to mental health, raising the possibility that it can form the basis of diagnostic or therapeutic tools. However, it's not an easy task to develop predictive tools or identify therapeutic interventions in the microbiome space. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of bacteria species, and the data are not only expensive to collect, but also very noisy and chock full of other challenges like high dimensionality, that is often many more microbes than human samples, sparsity, that is many microbes can be randomly missing from the data, and irregularity due to technical biases in the high throughput sequencing assays. What we do know is that it's a hot field with lots of potential, and so many researchers have thrown their hat into the ring. This means there are many disparate small studies researching related questions, albeit using slightly different protocols. We believe that there's a gold mine of data ready to be mined. Our proposed research project will harness the lake public data for two tasks. The first is to perform a systematic review of the microbiome and mental health literature, complete with a quantitative meta-analysis of published studies. The second is to perform a so-called mega-analysis, where we will combine the available data to create one big data set and use it to train a portable deep learning model that can be leveraged for transfer learning tasks. That is, to take a model trained on from one big data set and move it over into smaller data sets. Completing these tasks would produce a short list of putative beneficial bacteria biomarkers, as well as a pre-trained deep learning model, both of which can support future clinical trials in the microbiome and mental health space, including longitudinal diagnostic and intervention studies. Because of the challenges I mentioned already, there does not currently exist a good generic method for harmonizing all the public data. As such, our proposed study is not only an exercise in performing the meta-analysis and mega-analysis, but is itself a methodological study that will draw upon our team's transdisciplinary expertise to create a robust algorithmic framework that enables this kind of study in the first place. By making this framework public, we hope to support similar data integration studies in other related microbiome and human performance domains. That's all for me today. Thanks everyone for listening.